sound barrier. So now I have obese levels according to national standards. So it starts to make me think, how does an obese guy get laid without paying for it, getting arrested for the fifth time? So if you're wondering, how do you add an assault on a police officer to a solicitation charge? It goes like this. So if you're a hooker, I can do this, right? So that's always great when that's in the paper. The next morning, the phone calls and she says, "Hey, didn't your uncle Willie teach you anything? You're supposed to have the hooker touch you, dumbass." So, but no, the whole thing about picking up hookers, it seems like it's an art form. There's all signs. So it's like the hookers down Canterbury Street. It's almost like a third base coach getting signs. It's like this: "I'm a hooker, I'm not a pig. Wait, wipe that stuff. I am a pig, but I'm not a cop." Just so you know, I have my period, so that means blowjobs only tonight. Just in case you're wondering, you might want to wrap it because I have HIV. So I don't know if you guys have watched the NBA Finals recently, but speaking of HIV, Magic Johnson was doing the like post-game reports. I still don't believe he has HIV. I just think it's another minority. Collect with a good doctor, collect with disability for life. I think he's so good at ESPN, paying him under the table just to keep the disability. But now we talk hookers and HIV. We'll talk about another subject near and dear to my grandma's heart, penis size. Penis size is actually the only reason why I've ever been to Michael's Arts and Crafts store. I just finished jerking off the Maxim magazine. I remember Jessica Elba was on the cover. I think she was 16 when the photos were taken, but she was 18 when I was jerking off, so that makes it okay. It's kind of like the same theory that nowadays when I jerk off in episodes of Full House. I know the way till Stephanie says how rude. It's kind of ironic. So, like I said, Maxim magazine is great because that was like magazines we could leave on our coffee tables. And you girls wouldn't think we're perverts. We would rather be Hustler and House. Chicks with dicks. I mean, that's the stuff we really want to be leaving on our coffee tables. No? You guys have all seen Hangover 2. Now you've seen that scene when they see the she-male, and there's two things that go through a guy's mind when they see a she-male. A, because I'd be fooled after six beers, and B, does it have a bigger dick than me? So, you know, I kind of care about etiquette. It makes me, you know, wonder what's the right thing to do in those situations. Do you tip the cable guy? Do you, you know, if you do get tricked, do you say, "Listen, I'm not going to blow you, but I'll get your hand job and get your cut she-male"? These are the things I think about when I'm on the shitter. Obviously, from the size of me, I know a lot of things in there. So, like I said, back to Maxim magazine. I finished jerking off, and Maxim had an article about penis size, and, you know, starts talking about the average male penis size, and now I'm intrigued. I want to know. So I have to figure out where to rank the rest of men. So I pop on down to Michael's. I head back to the back apartment. I go to the sewing area. I get myself a little sewing kit, one of those tailor measuring things. And I go check out, the woman's like 70 years old, ringing me up, and she's like, "Oh, how cute, the young man in the sewing." And I just didn't have the heart to tell her I was going home to measure my cock. So I got home, I threw an episode of Full House on, and got ready. I gotta say, I'm slightly above average. That's easy. I was 19 when she got pregnant. that's an easy one to figure out where I went wrong. But the second one, I put a little more thought into that, and I was like, well, was I cheating on her the whole time? Was that what caused it? And I'm like, she must have known about that. All guys cheat all the time. Was it the fact that she was cheating on me the whole time? And I was like, no, I had no clue. Was it the fact that I shit the bed on the honeymoon? That's exactly what it was. So, we're in Cancun, and, you know, it's Wednesday, we're halfway through, and lying in bed, and we're on the honeymoon, so that means we actually had sex. It seems the girls just give sex during honeymoons, but after that it ends, and lying there naked, so bad about things. And feeling pretty good, we've been together for a while, and I feel something brewing, so I'm like, might as well let that go. And so, oh shit. And I checked, and I went, literally. So I hopped up and I left a handsome girl shirt all over the bathroom. And that's when I think our marriage ended. All right, that's all I got. Thank you very much.